It doesn't list the health and human safety of those of us on the Treasure Coast, those people on the West Coast. And that's what we're working on the Corps with the Corps of Engineers on, saying, you need to change this. You need to update this. You need to make this a priority. This is part of your job. Poisoning people in other communities should not be something that's allowed to happen. And you're allowing it to happen. And this needs to come to an end.
An algae crisis threatening our Treasure Coast.
A cycle of despair and disgust amidst promises made and broken.
Billions of gallons of water are rushing from Lake Okeechobee to our coastline.
How much pollution is too much? How much danger is too much? How much before this will stop?
I had a hearing with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, the second in command with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and we talked about one thing specifically. They have a very outdated chief's report that regulates everything having to do with management of the South Florida area, the Central Florida area.
When we're talking about these chief's reports, it is an issue that the chief's report mentions very specifically the things that will be managed. And it doesn't mention anything about the water quality, which in many cases is a state issue, but you did mention it is an issue in what's going on with Central and Southern Florida policies. So in that, I would ask, are you aware of some of the water quality issues? One of our most recent tests, which is in line with other tests, is said that the sample was 495 parts per billion of microcystin algae, a toxin. That's what's being discharged out of the lake into an epicenter of human population. That's an issue of water quality. And so I would ask, do you think that the 1948 chief's report could be updated? It could be looked at as dated, and there's potential to put something in place that mentions health and human safety as being a factor?
All right, yes, sir. So certainly there's always room for updating. I want to be clear, we don't have the authority to regulate water quality. The state's responsibilities for water quality in your region are very clear in the Clean Water Act, and as you mentioned, the Central and South Florida authorities. But sir, no, this is a partnership going down the Central Everglades Restoration Program. We want to do our part with the state and all of our partners to help those communities.
Well, in that, in talking about the balance between state and federal relationship there, the Army Corps feasibility study from 1999 on this issue, it reads, water quality improvement must be an integral part of all hydrologic restoration. It also reads, several plan components and other project elements are included to improve water quality conditions. It also reads, Water Resources Development Act of 2000, which established the Central Everglades Restoration Project in public law. It lists protection of water quality as a specific authorization. So water quality is the intent of Congress. I just listed off three specific places. It's clear that water quality is the intent of Congress. And so it's in that I would like to ask you, can you work with me on addressing the fact that this issue, this human health and safety issue that is related to water quality, is not listed in this chief's report? Can your office, can the Corps work with me on making that a piece of a chief's report when managing this system?
Yeah, yes, sir. I would welcome this dialogue with you and your team.
Thank you. I yield back.
The health effects of this coming into our community are, if somebody were to drink a glass of that water, it could literally cause liver failure. Or if somebody were to be swimming in that water and they're ingesting that water, that's something that leads them towards Alzheimer's. These are known toxins coming into our waterways where people recreate, where they're boating and they're fishing and kids are playing. It's the backyards of tens of thousands of people. It's where people are out there having to work on a daily basis, building docks, working in the marine services industry that have to get in and out of this water on a regular basis. I've talked to some of them who are telling me they're bleaching off after they get out of this water because they're so concerned with this water that they're having to get in. This affects people that are just trying to live their life in terms of enjoying a quality of life. And this affects people that are just going to work every day, trying to do their job, do the things that provide for their families. Their health is being put at risk because of these discharges. It can stop, and it has to stop. One of the bills that I introduced recently was the Stop Harmful Discharges Act. This is important because when you look at what's being managed on Lake Okeechobee, nowhere is it written that they will take into priority the health and the safety of people on the Treasure Coast of Florida or people on the West Coast of Florida who, as a result of keeping all that water on the lake, are getting these toxic discharges because it creates an emergency situation where too much water ends up on Lake Okeechobee, and the Corps of Engineers is telling us that if they don't send it our way, then the dike could fail. This bill that we introduced, the Stop Harmful Discharges Act, would say health and human safety has to be the priority. That has to be the priority of what's done out there, looking at how this affects people's children's, people's spouses, how it affects the people that are out there working in the water, how it affects the people that want to go out there and jump off a dock or go fishing or go out on a boat in our area. How does it affect the health and the safety of people in the Treasure Coast and on the West Coast? This is not written at all, and this is what this bill takes care of. This is a priority. It has to be made a priority. It's a priority to us. It hasn't been a priority to those that have been making the laws so far, and we're going to change that.
Right now, famed environmentalist Erin Brockovich was on the Treasure Coast this weekend, and she announced her support for a bill being pushed by Congressman Brian Mast to make the Army Corps of Engineers take our health and safety more seriously.
It sickens me to see what is happening up and down the state to your environment, to your tourism, to your businesses, to the animals, to the wildlife, and to the people. Water should not be a political issue. This is everybody's issue. It's wrong what's happening, and it does me good to see what really is a movement down here to stop these toxic algae blooms, stop what's happening with the pollution, the people. It is time for you to rise up. Water your states, your ecosystem, your health, your families, the animals. It is worth the fight. And I am just warm to my soul to be here, to see legislation introduced, to seeing Congressman Mast stepping up, doing the right thing. All of the groups, the organizations, the foundations, the people, it's been an outpouring to save Florida, stop the issues, stop these algae blooms. There's solutions. We need to find them, and we're going to make them happen.